All right, time now for Better Pets.
When you see a dog poking his head out of a car window looking so happy, it's hard not to smile. They really seem to enjoy the ride.
But you have to be careful because as a pet parent, you really don't want your pet to get hurt. And if they're not properly secured, your best friend could be in a little danger.
Here to talk about being safe on the road with your dogs and your cats, who don't always love it as much, is our Better Vet, Dr. Andrea Dennis. Thank you for being here. Wasn't Mr. Pitbull so cute?
Yes, you were in love, and I think it was reciprocal.
Yes, I think a chihuahua is in your future.
I need him to come back.
I know. Oh, yeah, he was absolutely adorable.
I often see these dogs poking their heads out the window, and they look so happy, and I'm like, I don't want to deprive them of that experience, and I'm sure their owners don't either, but there are pitfalls to having this happen.
There absolutely are, and the thing is, you can let them, you know, enjoy the fresh air, but you don't have to have their heads and partially their bodies. So maybe having the window partially open would be fine, and also we're going to have show you a couple of pictures of harnesses where they can still be safe in the back seat.
Okay.
All right,
okay.
So we have different issues. One of the reasons I love coming to do the show here is because you are pet lovers.
Yes.
Our producer is a pet lover, and she saw these dogs just running loose in the back of a pickup truck.
That's horrible.
Bad.
Yeah.
Right. So, again, what we want to do is make sure that we've got them secure. Now, what happens in the front seat? If you put your cat or dog in the front seat and they are not in a carrier and you are in an accident, that airbag is going to go off, and they're going to get hurt just from the airbag. So if you have to have them loose in the car, you want to put them in the back seat.
Okay.
The other thing is just, it's so much safer, as you both know, with cats, having them in the carrier.
Yeah, yes. I would never let my cat out.
No, that's sort of number one on our list, is you must have a carrier. Now, it doesn't just have to be for cats. They come in all different sizes. We have a couple of sizes here with us, too, and in a bit we'll show you how the right way to put a cat in the carrier.
Okay.
But, you know, they can even have like a 50-pound dog can be in a crate or a carrier.
Really?
But just to put those points up again, yeah. The safety barrier, so we got the carrier, mm-hmm. which we'll talk about, but a safety barrier and a harness. I'm not so sure I do part.
Yeah, we've got some photos. We've got some photos that will probably help explain. The carrier is a little bit self-explicit. So you've got not quite Mr. Pitbull's, but you know, you can see
small
this
dog.
One. It's a small dog, and you don't want the crate to be too big. You want them to have enough room where they can stand, turn around, and lay down, and that's because if it's too big and they get jostled, that's not good as well. So
okay.
Use, when you do decide to purchase, really read the guidelines or talk to your veterinarian or the people in the store about the right size for your pet.
You know, my cat likes smaller areas, so they tend to like a smaller cage.
Yes, and that's why, you know, I brought the smallest ones. I think the smaller, that as long as they can stand and turn around, you know, you don't want them so tight in there that it's a squeeze.
All right, we just saw a German Shepherd.
Yeah, the German Shepherd. This is where Kara was talking about. This is where you have this protection in the back seat. So that's a gate-like apparatus, so they can't jump in the front or they can't jump into the passenger side.
Is that the trunk then?
Yeah, that's like the hatchback.
I'm sorry.
And so that keeps them very secure in that area. And, of course, they're not going to have their head poking out the window either.
And then they don't need to be in a separate carrier? He can just be like that?
He could be just like that,
okay.
Right. But those are for the larger size. Now, this is the harness. This is where the back seat, definitely the back seat of the car, you want to, one, make sure the harness fits properly, and two, then it just sort of snaps right into your seatbelt. So that's the safe way. Now, in some states, this is the law. New Jersey has made it a law that your animal has or your dog has to be harnessed like that.
Would you use that for a bigger dog? Do they make them?
They do. I mean, like 40, 50 pounds easily can, at least it's secure in the back seat.
This is a silly question.
Yeah.
Let's say you have a giant dog, you know, Bernard, Great Dane. Can you just put a regular seatbelt around him while they're sitting?
No, you can't. They're not going to keep still, Kara. She is a cat owner. That's okay. We'll excuse it. No problem. But again, and the thing, I'm going to talk about the law piece of it. Again, in Connecticut, we have a law that you can't keep an animal in an open truck in the back. How many times have you seen pickup trucks and the dogs are just, they have to be secured. And the other thing is that you can be stopped if you have your dog on your lap. And that is
I see the word. That you talk about distracted driving.
Right.
Drivers with dogs on their laps.
Right,
right.
And cats are just as bad. They'll crawl under your feet, and they don't usually like the car, so they're meowing and they're going crazy. I think cats are really distracting.
Absolutely. That's why the crate is so important. And then sometimes they're on the lap and they're full.
We got about a minute left, so whatever you want to get to.
Well, I want to just show you really quickly on the crate, if I can do that.
Yeah, absolutely.
So this is the small crate that we were talking about. A lot of cats, when you open up the door, they don't want to walk in,
right? No, they don't.
All right, so there are, I didn't bring it with me, but there are crates where you have the door open and you also have the door on
top. That's the one I have, yeah.
Those are ideal, so they can drop them in.
Yeah.
Right.
Or you can turn it up.
Very good. Or you can turn it upside down, and that's not cool. And then I'm going to, I'll put this in. Yeah. And then what you want to do with your kitty cat, as I'm losing my microphone, is you hold them in the front arms, support them on their bottom, and then gently drop another.
No, but here's the thing. You go, okay, go.
And then really quick. But gravity is on your side.
Thank you, Scott.
But the other thing, too, that I'm going to just show, because cats a lot of times will go to the bathroom, always have something absorbent in the bottom. Have something absorbent in the bottom
I've
there.
I've never seen my cat go to the bathroom or puke in 2 minutes. They get in that cage, and they're like, I'm out. I'm done.
But also, too, what's nice is just leaving these crates out. You know, at all times, having a couple something like food in there, a little catnip.
Yeah,
just
so they get used to it.
Yeah. Very nice. Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Dr. Dennis. You're and welcome. As a reminder, Dr. Dennis is the owner of the Bloomfield Animal Hospital on Old Windsor Road, in Bloomfield.
On alternating Saturday afternoons from 2 to 3, she's taking listener questions during Pet Talk on WTIC 1080 Radio. So tune in for that if you can.